Shirley King and her lawyer map out civil action against the state. King claims the police violated her civil rights. She detailed what really happened at her sentencing. We'll hear that and from a juror who sat through the 14-week trial. Also tonight, do people in the Tompkins County Courthouse feel safe? Brenda Johnson will tell us how some county employees are joining hands and pushing for more security. And in this week's Health Beat, Russ Maines tells us about a panel discussion that brings AIDS face-to-face with the community. In sports, Michael looks at a closer look at the Bombers' first season loss at Cortland State. And get ready for warmer but rainier weather. News Center 7 is next. Stay with us.
This is Will Cook. We're celebrating a birthday at Bilko Cadillac Olds. The oldest American car company, Oldsmobile, just turned 95. My 92-year-old grandfather, Bill Cook Sr., has been with Olds for 44 of his 74 years in the business. He'll tell you that the Oldsmobiles we're selling today are the best-built cars he's ever seen. I'll tell you that with our old celebration prices, they represent an unbeatable value. See why we're celebrating 95 years of Olds and looking forward to 95 more at Bilko Cadillac Olds, Trip Hammer and Route 13, Ithaca.
Flavors mingle in the Thai tradition of cooking. Every sauce and entree is delicately prepared using favorite recipes and fresh herbs and spices. Experience the taste of Thailand for yourself at Thai Cuisine.
Now, from the studios of American Community Cablevision, Tompkins County's number one choice for local television news, this is News Center 7.
Shirley King and her lawyer plan to collect from New York State. Right now, it's just in the form of a notice of intent to file a claim with the state attorney general's office. They're looking for money damages against New York State. It doesn't say how much money they're looking for. The notice states that they're filing because of misconduct and fraudulent conduct of the now-fired New York State police investigator, David Harding. The notice filed with the Attorney General says King suffered mental anguish, pain, and suffering since February of 1990, and that the New York State Police deprived her of her civil rights. Yesterday, the felony charges against King were thrown out in Tompkins County. She still faces possible indictment in Onondaga and Cayuga counties. Shirley King spoke for more than 10 minutes at her sentencing back in early 1991, stating for the record that it was her belief that she did not receive a fair trial and had nothing to do with the crimes in the Harris home.
On December 23rd, 1989, I committed a crime. That crime was using a credit card that did not belong to me. Twice in Auburn and twice in Camillus. While I am not proud of having done so, that is all I did. Nothing more and nothing less.
King said police were loose with the truth.
One of these witnesses flat out lied about fingerprints and about conversations with me, and about other things like wiping the can clean so that it might be shiny. I'm sorry that justice has to wait for another day.
And joining us now is Jack Dougherty. He was a juror in the King trial. Jack, does she deserve an apology from the jury?
Not from the jury, no. The jury was basing their decision on the evidence that was presented to them, and we had no reason at that time to doubt any of the evidence that was given to us.
Did you wish at the time that you had heard from Shirley King that she had taken the stand in her trial?
I thought it was a little unusual that she did not, but I figured that that was just the method that the defense attorney thought was most appropriate.
What about you as a juror? You sat through this 14-week trial, and now with the chain of events that have happened in the last few months, how do you feel about your time spent in that role?
It isn't so much just the time. It's that I feel that we were used, or that I was used anyway, and I don't feel too happy about that.
In retrospect, I know this is a tough thing to say, we're playing Monday morning quarterback here, but what do you think about David Harding's testimony now?
Well, now, looking back on it, of course, I wonder if he told any of the truth.
Did you think he was a good witness at the time?
He was an excellent witness. Looking back on it, you might think he might have been too good. He was very glib.
You feel like you were used as a juror, don't have a lot of things good to say about David Harding. What about the state police? A lot of people are shaking their head about the system now.
Well, I learned a lot about the state police organization during that trial, and came out of it with a lot of admiration for them as an organization. I don't think what several people in that organization has done really shakes my faith in the state police.
So we still have yet to hear about really what's going to come out of that investigation, but you felt all in all...
I still feel that the state police are a good organization.
Certainly 14 weeks of your life you'll never forget, I'm sure.
True.
Okay, Jack, thanks for coming in tonight.
Thank you.
Well, recent events have county employees questioning their safety on the job. As Brenda Johnston reports, some courthouse employees are pushing for stricter security measures.
It was a month ago that tragedy struck Watkins Glen. A man walked into a Schuyler County building, shot and killed four employees, then turned the gun on himself. That hit too close to home last Friday. A man called the Tompkins County Family Court Clerk's Office and threatened to harm the employees. Incidents like these prompted courthouse workers several weeks back to circulate a petition. More than 60 people signed up for better security. Employees want a number of improvements. One would be that the public could only go into the building through one entrance, and they'd have to be screened by a metal detector.
The petition didn't ask for additional staffing, but that will probably be inevitable because metal detectors have to be staffed. And if they are staffed, then the rest of the building continues to need to be guarded, and the state pays for the deputy sheriff that guards this building full-time during business hours.
Heyman says the state has agreed to pay half the bill for a metal detector and additional security officers. There is currently one. Petition organizers talked with me off camera. They'd be happy with just one more officer in the courthouse.
On the whole, I'd say that our security is not different from other counties similarly situated, but at the same time, that's not altogether reassuring given the type of people we have to deal with.
I think it would also make me feel comfortable if there, you know, if the officers were walking around or, you know, just checking on us every now and then. Yeah, more visibility would definitely make me feel better.
The county administrator is hopeful. He says some of these requests could go through within a few weeks. Brenda Johnston, News Center 7.
A key witness takes the stand in a Tompkins County drug trial. The trial of Lee Longton continued today with testimony from an informant who described making two undercover cocaine buys from a town of Dryden, Man. Longton could face as much as 25 years to life in prison if convicted on the most severe charges. He is currently free on bail. The case is expected to go to the jury's hands early next week. Police are still looking for two men who allegedly tried to rob the Village Grocery in Jacksonville over the weekend. Police say the two white men in their mid-20s did not carry any weapons with them when they allegedly held up the store. They say when a clerk ran out the door and started screaming, both men fled the area without any money. Here's a look at one of the men. He's described as 6 feet tall, 170 to 190 pounds, with brown, medium-length hair, a beard, and a mustache. If you have any information, you should call the Sheriff's Department at 272-2444. Up next, Bridging the Gap in the city's south side. We'll tell you how law enforcement and residents are communicating and taking action.
Look next door. Tree Farms is bigger and better than ever. Treeform's Furniture Outlet has the largest selection of the best solid wood entertainment units, bookcases, desks, occasional tables, and more. In oak, pine, and cherry, as well as factory seconds and closeouts at big discounts. It's a shopper's paradise, and the prices are hot. Treeform's Furniture Outlet, 1302 Dryden Road in Ithaca.
I am pleased to report that the United Way of Tompkins County has raised over $600,000 toward our goal of $1.54 million. Hundreds of local volunteers are out working to ensure the continuation of United Way support for crucial services for area residents. If you have not yet had an opportunity to contribute to this year's campaign, I encourage you to do so. Simply call the United Way office at 272-6286.
Ithaca's premier wine and tapas bar and restaurant is Just a Taste, with over 50 wines on tap by the Taste Glass Bottler Flight. Serving lunch, dinner, and late-night snacks, it's Just a Taste off the Ithaca Commons.
Spreading the word about a growing threat. Across the community and the local colleges, experts say there is a growing awareness of AIDS and the virus that causes the disease. In this week's Healthbeat, Russ Maines tells us about one program that can teach us about living with HIV and AIDS.
Well, Molly, Cornell AIDS Action is composed of students and faculty members and staff who are boosting the community's knowledge. And tonight they've got a very special program that brings community members together with people who have AIDS or the virus that causes it.
The statistics are staggering. One in 250 Americans is infected with the HIV virus. New York State has over one-fifth of all AIDS cases in the United States, and on local college campuses, it's a big issue. Statistics show that nearly half of people with HIV virus are in their teens and 20s. Tonight, the coordinator of a campus-based AIDS education group will moderate a discussion. Five people with AIDS or the HIV virus will be sharing their stories.
Several of the people are asymptomatic. Several have had more serious symptoms. We hope they'll talk some about that. They'll talk about their families, their reactions, how their friends have treated them, what it's been like working with people and telling them that they're HIV positive, what they envision for the future.
People at the Gannett Health Clinic say the awareness is obvious. About 120 members of the Cornell community come there for HIV testing every month.
It's completely anonymous, and a lot of people come down all the time to do it. And it's great that they are. So we really encourage it. And it seems like a lot of people are very enthusiastic about finding out and practicing safe behaviors.
Tonight's panel discussion is open to the public. It's at the Goldwin Smith Auditorium, Lecture Room D, and it's at 7:30 p.m. HIV antibody testing is free. It's available at Cornell by calling 255-3978. Or for the general public, 1-800-562-9423.
Russ, is there any word on how many people in our community have been infected with the virus?
Well, the statistical information, unfortunately, isn't broken down that way. It's based on where the person is diagnosed as opposed to where the person lives. Mm-hmm. However, they do point out that since more of the people are younger, that because of the colleges, that it's more important to be aware of it.
Okay, thanks. The Southside community and the Ithaca Police are forming more than a bond. They are uniting and trying to better understand each other. A task force set up by the city's mayor has released its report on community police relations. A major request calls for hiring more police officers and getting them into the Southside more often.
That there was a desperate need to have the kind of casual daily basis interaction between an officer and the community, where they would get to know each other, perhaps on a first name basis.
Lewis says there is a perception throughout the South Side that white police officers are bad guys.
5 months ago, we had a multitude of complaints coming in, especially from our young men in the community. Complaints concerning harassment, unfair treatment, a few police brutalities. Most of the time it was considered unfounded, but we still did get those complaints. And now we're getting fewer and fewer complaints. I think
the report is available in City Hall, and it will eventually make its way to City Council for support, and many hope for funding. A Syracuse developer is making headway with his plans to construct a building in the city of Ithaca. Thorn Tree Hill Associates won't say who would occupy the building that will go on this site. However, the retailer isn't confirming. The city's Board of Zoning Appeals has made some progress by changing the status of a portion of the land to commercial use. The next step for Thorn Tree is the city's planning board, which requires a site plan and an environmental review of the property. Still to come, some milder weather's headed our way. Brenda's in next with the weather forecast. Stay with us.
Green Tree Nursery and Garden Center have the biggest, the smallest, and the most varieties of pots you will find. We have clay pots 1 to 26 inches in diameter, round, oblong, rectangular, and square pots, pots for the herb or orchid grower, pots for the solarium, the sunroom, or the kitchen window, bonsai pots, decorator pots, and grower pots of all sizes. Pots, plants, and soil. Green Tree Nursery and Garden Center, 308 the Elmira Road.
Contemporary Trends, corner of Seneca and Aurora Streets, is your center for fine Scandinavian and American furniture of timeless design and beautiful craftsmanship, as well as crystal china and many other home accessories of good design. Contemporary Trends in downtown Ithaca.
Handwork is Ithaca's cooperative craft store where 30 local members and other artists from around the country sell directly to the public, keeping our prices affordable and the selection wonderful. Stop by and see what's new at Handwork.
Hello, Battery Warehouse and Auto Accessories. Can I help you?
We can get you started at Battery Warehouse and Auto Accessories, offering a complete line of gas tanks and radiators, corner of Route 13 and 3rd Street. Stop in for a free charting system check.
Another new addition at Shortstop is the Hot Stuff Pasta Bar. Serve yourself. You can choose the exact amount you want, top with the sauce you want, all for $1.98 per pound. Add meatballs and sausage a la carte. At Shortstop, the original Ithaca-style deli. Now you can choose from 13 varieties of Paul DeLima Special Reserve Coffee. Piping hot, fresh brewed, and ready for your enjoyment. Choose from the best at Shortstop, the original Ithaca-style deli.
Tonight's weather report is brought to you by Simeon's on the Common, serving the local community with a full menu selection from 11 in the morning until 12:30 at night.
Brenda, I think it's too early to have it be this cold.
Well, the good news is it's going to warm up the next couple of days, but you're going to have to take your umbrellas out with you. So you have to compromise for the warmer temperatures. Let's look at today. 49, that was about 1 in the afternoon. The record high, 74 in 1931. The low, 33. The record low, 16 in 1961. No rain today. That brings the monthly total to 1.29 inches. Outside right now, the skies are cloudy. The temperature is 36 degrees. Humidity, 45%. The barometer is falling. And the winds are out of the south at 12 miles an hour. Temperatures around Tompkins County today. Lansing 38 for the low, Groton 45, Trumansburg 41, Podunk 46, the high in Dryden and in Newfield, both with 48. Around New York State, not quite as nice as Tompkins County, Watertown 37, Rochester 37, Syracuse 36, Elmira and Albany 38, Binghamton 33, and New York City 39. Let's take a look at the national map. If you've noticed, it got a little warmer today and even into the afternoon. That's because of that high pressure system sitting off the eastern coast. That's going to combine with a low pressure system over Minnesota and bump some warm air into central New York for tomorrow. The good news is the bad news is along with that warmer air, we're going to get some rain. Now we got a quick shower or two today. A cold front will move into the area tomorrow. That'll give us about a 60% chance of rain, but the temperatures will remain mild and in the 50s for Wednesday. Straight ahead for tonight, there'll be mostly cloudy skies with a chance of some rain, lows of about 38 degrees. For tomorrow, a 60% chance of showers, but the sun could peek out here and there. It'll be windy, highs of about 57 degrees. The extended outlook, Thursday, more rain, clearing up for Friday, but you can see by the end of the week, some chance of some snow. I'll get that out. And Molly, it's going to chill
off. So enjoy the warmer weather while we have it.
Or just the next couple of
days.
Right. All right, thanks. Coming up in sports, Michael takes a look at that painful Bomber football loss and asks the question, why did it happen? And the Cornell hockey season opens up this weekend. We'll see how they're looking next.
Someday, selling a house may be as simple as pushing a button, but until then, sales are best accomplished by those with the experience it takes to market your property. RE/MAX.
Selling homes now. RE/MAX. Experience.
Is your house full? Full of remotes? Face it, friend. You've got too many remotes. Wipe your coffee table clean. You need ACC's new and improved Universal Remote. Operate your television, VCR, stereo, and cable box with one remote. It's unbelievable, but it's true. ACC's new and improved Universal Remote. Call now for details.
Viewers of the world unite. You have nothing to lose but your remotes.
Diane Willard's first son, Jason, was born 16 weeks premature. When she first noticed a disability in him, she took him straight to the Special Children's Center.
I must say, I feel that the people at the Special Children's Center have been very attentive to his needs. Definitely the early intervention that has occurred at the Special Children's Center, the care of the people, the concern of the people, has been extremely important to his developmental delays to help him get up to his normal peer group.
The Special Children's Center receives significant financial assistance from the United Way. Please help.
A lot has changed in the 77 years that W.T. Pritchard Dodge has been serving the needs of Tompkins County.
But some things remain the same, like the Pritchard family ownership and commitment to service and Dodge quality.
Let us show you the popular Dodge Caravan, Dodge Spirit, and the sporty state-of-the-art Stealth. Come see the quality of Dodge in our 1992 models and used vehicles. W.T. Pritchard Dodge, South Cayuga Street, Ithaca. We take pride in serving you.
Sports and tonight's football trivia is sponsored by Aladdin's Natural Eater and Dryden Road in College Town, featuring all natural soup, salads, pita dishes, hot and cold drinks, and scrumptious desserts with carry out available.
As long as we're talking about very cold weather, we might as well talk about hockey.
Sir, a lot of questions coming in this year's Cornell hockey season. Hopefully some of them answered Saturday night. The Cornell University men's hockey team gearing up for the opener. Preseason practices and scrimmages are through. And the team gets right to business Friday night, entertaining ECAC rivals Princeton and Yale on Saturday. The Big Red, after playing in the red-white scrimmage last week, took on an outside opponent in the University of Waterloo this past weekend. Andy Bandersky made his second collegiate start and is the heir apparent of the departed Paris Duffus. Bandersky started slow, giving up four first-period goals, two in the game's first 2 minutes, but then he settled in and made 21 saves. Meanwhile, last year's squad was strong defensively, but had trouble scoring. Well, if Saturday was any indication of things to come, Cornell has a handful of players in the back of the net. That's Ryan Hughes, the co-captain, as he blasts one past the keeper for one of his two on the night. Right wing Mark Skolin looks to add to his second of the night, but dishes at the last second to Sean Hanna, who finished up with the hat trick. Cornell wins the scrimmage 9-5, and we'll hear from Coach McCutcheon and some players before they open up this weekend. Well, the Ithaca College football team suffered its first setback over the weekend, and because of the loss to Cortland, the Bombers have lost the top spot in the NCAA Division III East Region football poll. The Bombers will occupy the number one for the first 8 weeks of the season, fall to number two. Rowan, formerly Glassboro State from New Jersey, moves into first. Buff State, Worcester, Polytechnic, Cortland, and Montclair follow the Bombers. Only the top four teams make the playoffs, and the Bombers begin their playoffs in all essence this weekend when they host the top team from the South, Washington and Jefferson. Well, why did the Bombers lose Saturday? Well, that's a good question. Clearly, Cortland dominated on both sides of the ball. Cortland quarterback Brian Wild, he had time to make a sandwich back there. No pass rush whatsoever. Wild completed 15 of 31 passes for 180 yards, while five different players for Cortland carried the ball for 153 yards rushing. Ithaca's D-line simply outplayed. The Red Dragons in the closing seconds of the first half moved the ball from the Cortland 36 to the Bomber end zone. It's a six-play drive in 48 seconds, and the Bombers can't afford that kind of ball movement from Washington and Jefferson. On the other side of the ball, the powerful offense was simply stymied. Poor Joe Fitzgerald. One completion out of 11 pass attempts. Portland's secondary not letting anything through and providing solid coverage. That forced Fitzy to either run it or throw it away. Fitzgerald did pick up 81 yards on the ground. Jeff Whitman had 108 yards, but was stopped at the times that the Bombers needed him most, like on a fourth and inches play. Ithaca special teams did win that battle, scoring two touchdowns. This week, all phases of Ithaca's game must be up to speed when they play host to the Presidents. WNJ is 8-0 and beat Cortland earlier this year 31-6. So for Ithaca, it is a playoff game. It's a must-win situation. A loss could mean an end to the season, and the team knows it has to bounce back.
A no-win situation where we have to win every game. I think if we lose next week, we're out of the playoffs. So we're playing the number one team in the South, and we're going to be geared up for it.
We see how much character Ithaca College has, and I know that we'll play. We'll bounce back. We got a great team.
The better. They have a big game next week by a team that handled Cortland with ease. So they know they have a job at hand, and they have to get ready to play.
And while the Cornell football team will be at Columbia Saturday, Shell Caulfield will be the site of the high school football bowl games at 11 o'clock. Lansing will play Hancock in the Class D Bowl. Bobcats looking to avenge their only regular season loss. Bowl 3 pits the only two undefeated teams left in Section 4, Windsor and Notre Dame. Class B at 4 has Norwich playing JC. And finally, Class A Bowl 6:30, Ithaca High against Binghamton. The Patriots looking to avenge their only regular season loss. I'll preview the Class A and D Bowls on Thursday and Friday. The Ivy League has published its final soccer release for the 1992 season, so let's take a look at the final men's standing. Dartmouth wins its second outright title in the past 3 years with a 6-1-0 Ivy record. Princeton followed, then Yale, Harvard, Columbia, Brown, the Big Red, and lastly Penn. Cornell gained its first 500 season since 1989. Nat Grew, Ted Lesh, and Pat Walsh lead the team with 4 goals and 1 assist. For the women, Yale and Brown are this year's co-Ivy League champions. Dartmouth finished third, and then Cornell, that disappointing fourth. Freshman netminder Kate Alexander finished second in overall goalkeeping, and Lori Penny finished third in the league with points, 11 goals, and 2 assists. The Ivy League will announce the all-Ivy teams tomorrow. And finally tonight, it's football trivia brought to you by Aladdin's Natural Eatery on Dryden Road in Collegetown. Be the first correct caller and win a pair of tickets to see an upcoming Ithaca College or Cornell football game. For tonight's question, here is last week's answer. What Cornell receiver holds the school record with an average of 20.5 yards per catch? Correct answer, Sean Hawkins from 85 to 87. Now tonight's question. Against what school did Jeff Whitman rush for a school record 270 yards? If you know the answer, call the number you see on the bottom of your screen. And tonight's correct caller will pick up a pair of tickets to see the Bombers' regular season finale against Washington and Jefferson. And I think we've already said, Molly, how important that game is.
And how tough they'll probably be, too. All right. Thanks, Michael. And we'll be right back after this.
Tune into the Marketplace every morning at 7:15 for a delicious look at today's Ithaca City School District's lunch menu. Brought to you by Creative Kids and the Marketplace.
The trust company wants you to feel comfortable with your investments.
With them, I do. They know me. I know them.
We provide complete investment and money management help.
They took time to explain which one was best for me.
Our money managers have earned a reputation for performance.
I love that.
Trust Department money managers take good care of you and your money. For more information, contact the Trust Department at the Tompkins County Trust Company.
Hi, I'm Ron Secord of Excelsior Systems. Now is the perfect time to start thinking of those high-cost energy bills. One great way to save is custom-fit solid vinyl replacement windows by CertainTeed. They'll keep you cooler in summer and warmer in winter. You'll never have to climb a ladder again to wash windows, hang storm windows, or screens. CertainTeed eliminates that need and provides easy indoor cleaning. Stop in for a free demonstration and estimate or call me at 277-0100.
I created Especially in Ithaca in 1986. My focus is on classic elements of fine handmade American home furnishings and jewelry in 14 karat gold and sterling silver. Engagement rings, wedding bands, and fashion rings for women and men. Elegant, comfortable jewelry for work or play. Whimsical variations on the classics. Plus silk scarves, lamps, clocks, and desk accessories, and garden sculptures. Especially in Ithaca, an eclectic collection of fine handmade American crafts next to Simeon's on the Ithaca Commons.
By popular demand, Hair Graphics East has expanded their Monday specials to Tuesday. Have your hair cut for just $8 with perms just $35. Offer good only at Hair Graphics East location.
And looking ahead to tomorrow, we'll show you how local veterans are observing Veterans Day. Also tomorrow in this week's Consumer Report, Lily Edie takes us to a place that gives consumers a different perspective on the environment. And Russ Maines will talk to an expert on some important hunting safety tips. That's all for tonight's show. Thanks for joining us. For the entire news team, have a good night. We'll see you tomorrow.